This is a very special piece we have to learn today, which will help us figure out how do we continue Shavuot. It's very much connected to the shir that Rabbi Judah Michelle gave earlier this week. What is the post-Shavuos avoiding depression syndrome really all about? And obviously what the Rebbe is going to do to Lubavitcher Rebbe, peace for him, is going to show us, don't look anywhere else but the Parsha. Look at the Parsha that usually, kimat always, shows up right after Shavuot, which is Nasso, in order to understand where do you go from here. But I think even more than just where do you go from here, what even happened there? What just happened a few days ago? So this is the Rebbe. Look at how he begins over here. Shabbat Parshat Nasso hi Shabbat shelifnei o acharei Chag Shavuot. It's always surrounding the Chag of Shavuot. ולכן יש ברמזים לתפקידו של האדם בימים אלה. Therefore, in the parasha itself of Shavuot, of Nasso, there are a lot of hints showing you, teaching you, what is, how should man act during these days. בתחילת הפרשה נאמר נשא את ראש. How does the Torah begin? The Shavuos, lifting up the head, נשא את ראש. והפרשה מסתיימת בפסוק, and the last pasuk of the parasha comes and says, ובבוא משה אל אוהל מועד לדבר איתו, וישמע את הכל מדבר אליו מעל הכפורת. As Moshe Rabbeinu comes to Oel Moed to talk to Hashem, he heard the voice speaking to him above the kaporet. בשני הפסוקים הללו יש רמז לעבודת השם המיוחדת לאחר מתן תורה. In both the opening pasuk of the parasha and the last pasuk of the parasha, there are remazim, there are hints, to specific avodat Hashem of the post-Shavuos energy. Post-Shavuos energy. הדבר הגדול שהתרחש במעמד הר סיני היה החיבור בין עליונים לתחתונים. The greatest thing that occurred at Har Sinai was heaven and earth joining, connecting, right? בין הקדושה האלוקית, between godly holiness, לבין המציאות הגשמית, to this materialistic reality. הקדוש ברוך הוא ירד למטה, וירד השם על הר סיני. השם came down, ומשה רבינו, כנציג עם ישראל, עלה למעלה. And משה רבינו, as the representative of עם ישראל, he went up, ויעל משה. So where there was on הר סיני, what ended up happening? Heaven and earth met, but who really met? Who came down and who went up?
Moshe and Hashem.
Moshe and Hashem. What about us?
Moshe was there as Hashem.
Not enough. now we're understanding.
Who saw his voice?
Ach b'sha'at ma'amad har Sinai. However, at the time of har Sinai, hurgesha yoter ha'itgalut shel HaKadosh Baruch Hu v'ha'yirida shelo lemata me'asher ha'itgalut shel Am Yisrael lemala. As much as you want to say that we met with God, what was felt more, what was sensed more? God coming down came on much harder than us feeling that we, through our shaliach, went up. But the point was that we meet, and not just that one is felt more than the other. לכן לאחר מתן התורה, therefore after the Torah was given, מתמקדת עבודת האדם בהתעלות עצמית, מלמטה למעלה. The focus now is man's work of self-elevation from below to up there. Meaning, until Matan Torah, I would assume that the highest I could reach was to have a godly revelation of Hashem coming down. And maybe that was true. But after the Torah is given to you, it means that we receive the vessels to now do the avoda of us meeting Hashem now. Before the Torah, this is like, we were talking about this a lot over Shavuos. What really changed during Shavuot? Like what transpired? What was the transformation? What opens up to a person when they invite Torah into their life? So before the Torah was given in the world, how could a person really experience transformation if there was a matnat chinam of Hashem coming down and appearing? But once the Torah was given, Hashem saying, listen, you want that kind of vibe, the kind of feelings? I want to give you so much more than just momentary moments of inspiration. I'm with you in everything.
You said Lapidim.
Exactly, the difference between Barak and Lapid. Very good. Now it's Lapid time, right? Now it's Lapid time. So what does that mean? It means you. It means you. Right, that'd be a bad thing if someone caught this right now and cut the video and said, you know, that I'm like voting for, you know, Yesh Atid, because I say it's Lapid animals. Time, huh?
Immigrants are animals.
From Barak to Lapid, we're getting so political. Amazing. From Ehud Barak to Yair Lapid. Now. I think now is the time to. Now it's you. Hashem is saying, you come and meet me. Now I came down to you, come and meet me. So the focus now, after Shavuos, is mamash working on ourselves in a way that we elevate ourselves back up. Because now there's no excuses. Because now I received the Torah. The Torah is the manual. Without a manual, I can maybe say, okay, you know what, Hashem? It's impossible to get close to you. But if I received it, that means Hashem is saying, you have it, and you can do it. You can go up.
I thought that was the work we were doing in Sefirot HaOmer. It was like adding layers, bringing ourselves closer.
The work, it's interesting. The work in Sefirot HaOmer seems to be more of, let me cleanse my vessels to receive you than Shavuot.
It's not like using your vessels in order to build myself.
Not yet. It's still, I don't think. But it's a very good, it's interesting you point that out. I'm sure some schools of thought look at it more like that, and the Rebbe's focusing on something else. But in line of what the Rebbe's saying over here, that's how I see it, that Shavuot, I'm cleaning up the emotional garbage, the emotional sfirot, right? In order so that when Hashem comes down and I have, there's room for Hashem in my heart. Now that happened, Naso et Rosh, lift up your head. Now you're going, movement towards up. How? This is what we're going to see. E if shah li stapek, we're in the fourth paragraph. E if shah li stapek bekach, shakdusha el yona meira milimata lemata. You can't be satisfied, you can't be li stapek. What's the right word? I guess satisfied is settled. It's not settling enough to know that there's kdusha coming down from above.
If man, honest from his own, where he's at, is not going up,
then there's not a real connection between what happened on Har Sinai of the higher world coming down to the lower world. This real chibur, this real connection, the real coming together between heaven and earth is only when man, the way that he is with his seichel and the kochos of his soul that he has, chooses to use those to connect to God. Haremez la'avoda ruchanit zo nitan b'rosh parshateinu u'besofa. And the remez for this work, when one has to do in himself, is given at the beginning of the parsha and the end. Because what's the beginning? Tchila, naso et rosh. And the end of the parasha speaks about going into the Ohel Moed and hearing the voice of God. And Rabbi is going to explain both avodas here. Naso et rosh, lift up your head, mevate et atzorech lehitromem ulehitalot. It expresses the need to go up, elevate, and to become exalted. What does he mean over here? Rosho shel ha'adam miteva briyato nitzav me'al kol evarei gufo. The way Hashem designed the body is that the head is above all other limbs. Ha'davar mevate et elyonuto shel ha'sechel shebarosh al hargashot v'hadchafim ha'tiviyim. I can't believe he's saying this. This is exactly what we're learning in the Tanya.
He's saying, if Hashem expected you to be led by your emotions in this world, then he would have placed your heart up above your head. Isn't that amazing? Mm-hmm. But since God, the way that Hashem, the Ratzon is to have your mind be that which, you know, governs the heart in a proper manner, therefore, physically, that's where Hashem placed the mind, the seichel. Same. Same level, yeah. Very good. Very good. I mean, look, we say every day, "V'lo tatur rachel levavchem," because why? This is what's supposed to latur. You know, and, I mean, this is what's supposed to be. In Tanya, basically, Avi, we're learning the whole concept is not to subdue emotions, but it's to be able to know how to navigate them. And that the way the navigation of the soul, of the emotions, is when the mind is in a state of being in awe of how great Hashem is. That's basically the balance of awe and fear, and how they both then are what they're placed into the heart. But the Rebbe is saying over here, if God wanted you to be led just by your emotions, then your physical feature would be different. But the reason why the moach, the mind, the intellect is up here, is specifically for that reason, because that's what's supposed to lead. That's what's supposed to, Nasso et rosh, lift up your rosh, not lift up your emotions, right? This is exactly what he said. Again, I want to read this this line again. Nasso et rosh mevatet atzorech lehitromem ulehitalot. Rosho shel haadam miteva briyato nitzav me'al kol evarei haguf. V'hadavar mevate, the notion that the fact that man, that the intellect, the brain, is physically situated above all other limbs of the body, it expresses elyonuto shel hasechel al haregashot v'hadchafim hativiim hameyutzagim b'shar chelkei haguf. You understand that? You understand, David? How would you say this? You would say that this basically expresses the fact that the seichel needs to be over and higher and above that which our body senses as a natural need. Af al pi chen, and nonetheless, the Torah commands us, naso et rosh. Even though it's physically situated where it is, lift up your head. Huh?
Place it where it should be.
Place it where it's. Tzarich la'rim afilu et arosh. Leharimo lenaso lemala likdusha. You might think, okay, I'm over here, I know that this is true, my mind is what needs to govern over the emotions, v'chule. But the Rebbe is saying, no, take that and don't use it for the world of just coming up with mental, academic gymnastics. Lift it up to Kedusha. Take that and don't become, I hate to say such words, but don't become someone who abuses the world and people's emotions because you're so smart. Lift up this, which is such a gift, to Kedusha. Humble yourself with it. Naso et rosh. He's saying, the Rebbe is saying, tzarich leharim et rosh. Even though it's here, you still need to lift it up. Even though you are aware that Hashem gave you a brain, now lift it up and fill it and infuse it with holiness.
Without the balance. You want your mind to govern your heart. You don't want your heart to sort of govern your mind.
To affect your mind.
To affect, like I'm just saying.
Right, so how does the heart affect the mind? By
having the hashpah in it.
By having the hashpah to eventually do what?
Yeah. Your mind should be making the decisions.
Rachon. Meaning having your heart remind the mind, okay, now lift yourself up. You want to be with Hashem too. You don't want it to be your own, room of operations, you want to do this inyan also. So that's a beautiful way of understanding how the heart goes back to the mind and says, Naso es rosh. That's beautiful. That's, I was having a conversation, was it with you? I don't know, with someone, with Ari this morning after Tani, he said to me, he said, it's so sad that the world looks at Lubavitch and unfortunately knows so much more about the Mashiach complexity and doesn't know about the brilliant, mind-boggling design of the soul that the Alter Rebbe introduced to the world.
Oh.
Huh? All of us. It's so it's such a fisfus. My God. Wow.
I didn't look down on them, but I had no idea about the depth of the Torah.
This is what he's saying. Look, listen, this a teaching like this, the Rebbe on Parshat Nasso, this is right out of the Tanya. It's not, you know, the Rebbe's chiddush. It's just basically saying this is mamash coming straight out of mamash, the prakim that we're learning right now in the morning.
Mashba'ut hadavar.
So the meaning of all this is she'adam nidrash lirumem et sichlo ve'et kol kochotav hanafshiyim ve'hagufanim ule'ha'amidam le'shirut hakdusha. The meaning of this is that it's time to enroll. It's time to enroll all the faculties of our intellect, as well as enrolling our emotional status, as well, wherever we're holding there as well.
בעוד שבעת מתן התורה עמד האדם בתחושה התבטלות מול עוצם הגילוי האלוקי.
When we were standing before God at Har Sinai, could you avoid bittul? It was so big, kolot ubrakim. I mean, the whole thing was so incredibly powerful. But now the Rebbe says, "Harei achshav alav lehaalot et kochotav ulishabdam legamre leavodat Hashem." He's saying, "Now it's you." Yeah, you said nasa v'nishma, but saying nasa v'nishma when there's kolos ubrakim, it's not exactly enough to keep you in check. Oh, that's interesting.
That's the part that we have to do.
Right, meaning the moach is your inyan afterwards.
Fine, we have our emotions. It doesn't take much to stir your emotions.
Oh, I thought you were saying something else. I thought you were saying it's a very good thing that it's not ke'ish echad b'moach echad, because each of us have to be connected in the heart and the mind, but the way that my perception of Hashem, it needs to be different than yours, because I might have something to show the world that, you know, someone else might need, and v'chule.
I'm thinking moach echad more in the sense that all of our seichel is being used to elevate our
that's beautiful.
So we all think the same way.
That's beautiful. That's beautiful. But what the Rebbe is saying over here is like after Shavuos, it's meaning a time of like, it's this time of it's your time to enroll. It's your chance to really enroll and actually show yourself that you're standing behind those two words, Nasa v'Nishma, because the point was to establish the chibur between the elyonim and tachtonim. Mm-hmm. Again, on Matan Torah and Shavuot, there was definitely a chibur, but it was felt much more mitzad that which came down, which is God coming down. Now it's you coming up, is mamash naso. Lift up your head, lift it up. Ketotzaa mikach, as a result of this, notzar hachibur hashalem ben elyonim v'tachtonim. As a result now of you enrolling and you enlisting and you lifting up your head, now there's a complete chibur between this concept of higher and lower. And how do we know this? Because the Rebbe says, now go to the end of the parasha. Hadavar nirmaz b'sof ha-parasha. Ubevo Moshe el oel moed v'yishma et hakol midaber elav. The Moshe Rabbeinu came to the oel moed and now he hears the voice talking to him. Zehu ha-matzav sheba-adam, kfi shehu, mitchaber ha-makadosh baruch hu. This is describing the quintessential yid. That in the beginning he lifts up his head, that he's taking himself seriously, and then you'll end up walking into the Olam Haba where you meet with God and you'll hear Hashem's voice.
Because you
go to his place.
As opposed to him coming to...
He already came to your Ol Moed.
Yeah.
Now it's you going to his Ol Moed. Exactly. Vayered Hashem al Har Sinai was basically saying, Ubevo Hashem el Ol Moed shel Am Yisrael. Right? But now it's the other way.
Mm-hmm. Like you said earlier, runs the
Beit Midrash. Yeah. Inyan, it's so beautiful. Inyan ze kayam bekol echad ve'echad. This exists within each and every one of us. בכל עת וזמן, anytime, בנפשו של כל יהודי נמצא משכן להשם. In every single soul, there's this משכן to Hashem. ושם אפשר לשמוע את כל השם. There you could hear the voice of Hashem. בכל יהודי יש גם ניצוץ מנשמת משה רבינו, ובאמצעותו מסוגל כל יהודי להגיע לאוהל מועד ולשמוע את הכל מדבר אליו. The Rebbe is saying, yes, the end of the parasha is speaking about Moshe Rabbeinu. But the Zohar HaKadosh already told us that there's a nitzotz of the neshama of Moshe Rabbeinu in each and every one of us. And each and every one of us have a mishkan, have a nefesh elokit. That's a place of meeting, that's the oel moed, where we can meet with Hashem, and we can actually hear Hashem talking to us. Omnam ein shom'im et hakol hazeh be'oznayim hagashmiyot. But you know what? You don't hear it with materialistic ears, physical ears. Ach haneshama achen shomat et kol Hashem. But the soul hears the voice of God. Oto kol shayab matan Torah. When it says kol gadol velo yasaf means that the voice never ended, it doesn't mean that if you're really quiet you could still hear the words Anochi Hashem Elokecha, but the soul hears it. The soul hearing something is establishing some kind of a da'at of the neshama. Just like right now, say the word, I don't know, choose a word to say.
Youth.
Fine, so now it was established right now that I could say that he said the word youth. What it does to me, I'm not sure, but I know that he said that. The soul knowing that something was said is not through words. It's listening to an inner voice going on in the neshama of man. And it knows it better than even that I, my physical ears, heard Yeshua say the word youth. You're thinking of Matisyahu right now? I don't know why I'm thinking about him today. I don't know. It's a good thing. I don't know. Who knows? What's going on up there? אותו קול שהיה במתן תורה הוא הקול שהקדוש ברוך הוא הכניסו למשכן העדות. The same voice that was at Matan Torah. This is the voice that Hashem brought in into the tabernacle of testimony. ושלאחר החורבן הלבישו הקדוש ברוך הוא בהלכות התורה. So everyone wants to know, where did that voice go after Matan Torah? And where did that voice go after the Churban HaBayit? This is what it means when it says, אין לו לקדוש ברוך הוא אלא דלת אמות של הלכה. It means the voice of Hashem is an expression of His will. That's what the voice of Hashem means. The voice of God coming down on Har Sinai was the complete revelation of God's will in this world, what He wants from us. Where is it now that there's no Beis HaMikdash? Because that's where that voice was. Like when you walked into the Beis HaMikdash, what did you basically hear? You heard the voice of Har Sinai. Since then, where is that same voice in? In the Torah. The words he says, "Ushulachar churban," after the destruction, "Hilbisho Hakadosh Baruch Hu b'ilchot haTorah." God enclosed that voice into the Torah. If so, imken al yedei hitchaskut belimut haTorah, by strengthening ourselves through the learning of Torah. Zochim legilui kol Hashem. You merit to receive this voice, the revelation of the voice of Hashem. Vaydaber elav mamash. Vaydaber elav mamash.
Pshat.
He's saying like something so pshat, yet so deep. Because what is he saying? Through this pshat, of basically learning more Torah, learning more about Hashem's will, what are you affirming more? The chibur between Shemayim v'aretz.
But that's only if Nasa Rosh.
Only if you live. But if you have to live Nachon, Nachon. Very strong. So it's almost like the finishing of like Har Sinai doing what it's supposed to do in the world is every single day we can make that meeting with God more and more chazak.
And it starts with the acknowledgement, recognizing
Nasa Rosh.
We have a neshama elokit. We have to raise our heads and channel all of the emotion that we're feeling constantly
towards
the
path
of Ratzon
Hashem. Yeah.
It also kind of redefines like a level of a nebuah. It's not like you direct nebuah, but it's like the idea of nebuah is if it's morning and I put it on tefillin because it's a minyan right now, I'm doing nebuah. I'm doing right. God just spoke to me. Because why? Right. I know the halacha and I know the Torah. Afterwards, I'm sitting in the shiur and trying to take things on a midot level to the world. I'm speaking to Hashem. Hashem's talking.
But think about this. When was the last time you put on tefillin with the understanding of I'm doing something right now physically based on something that my mind taught me? Well, you know what the problem with a lot of FFBs, including myself, big time, is that I just know this stuff because I grew up with it. So what element of my experience is lacking? There's no Nasso, it's Rosh. Because I never really lifted up my head to learn this and realize that this is something godly. It's something that I do because it's my Masoret. Now, is there Kedusha in it? Of course, there's inherent Kedusha in it. I didn't establish that. That's Hashem established the Kedusha of the fact that these are mitzvahs, right? But it means that we should probably be learning all the stuff that we're already doing.
That's why you have kids. Yeah, it's true.
The most petrifying thing in the world when they come. So Abba, why do we wear tzitzit? Oh, because Hashem. You can't. The product of children we're raising here in Eretz Yisrael today, you can't get away with this stuff. Your boys, your son grilled me, Leil Seder. Yeah. We're walking home from shul.
You did.
But what does it mean, nishtana? Like, I understand you're telling me it means it's different, but why couldn't the Haggadah say, Mashoneh, what is the inyan of Nishtana? And I realized, like, wow, he's not trying to irk me.
Yeah.
He really has a real deep ratzon to lift up our heads and understand what we're doing. Beautiful. So we have a lot, you know, Baruch Hashem, we have a privilege after Shavuos here to just continue the chibur between Shemayim v'Aretz, but this time, it's me going up. Beautiful. I'll take this. Thank you so much.